Holy shit, look at this monster. What up, y'all? It's your boy, Plant Man P, and we are in the Bay Area this week. And you already know work don't stop. Dropping off some packages for you guys. This way. So yeah, we are in the Bay Area this week. Work is done. Now it's time for play. We're going to take you guys with us to Encinial Nursery. Been there once before. They had some fire stuff, so hopefully they have some fire stuff again. We're gonna check that out, see what they got, bring you along with us, and if we buy something, we'll let you know. But again, we're in the Bay Area this week. Probably by the time we get back to LA, this video is probably gonna be out. I would say, matter of fact, still drop some comments down below as to your favorite Bay Area nursery, and if we haven't visited or if we haven't made a video on it, we'll check it out this week or next time we're in the Bay Area, because we're always here. So let's go ahead and go to Encinial Nursery and check it out. By the way, this is a long sleep therapy tea. If you want it, comment down below. We're gonna be dropping it soon, but we are here at Encinial Nursery. Let's go ahead and check out what they have. Can't go wrong with the Amex. Last time we were here, we didn't even bother to check out the succulent section they had. Or selection, rather. We just went straight to the house plants. It's pretty dope. If I remember correctly, everything is pretty fairly priced here. They got some pretty good stuff here. At first glance, nothing that I would purchase myself right now. But maybe when I look off camera, I'll probably find some stuff. If my spidey senses are correct, this is a variegated string of pearls for $29.50, which isn't bad, I would think. Dope pottery they got here. Right off the bat, everything's pretty cool. Would I be purchasing anything? I'm not sure. But again, off camera, I'm gonna double check, make sure I'm not missing anything. and then I'll let you guys know.
You wanna see something?
Came out empty-handed.
They had stuff, but not really much that I would purchase or we already had or something like that, but
they had a good selection though.
Would definitely recommend this spot to someone who's like just getting into the plant game or has landscaping in the crib they need to get you know, stuff for. But yeah, overall I would say I give it like a 6 or 7 out of 10. It was pretty cool. Last time I came they had way more stuff. This place is where I got my Philodendron Jungle Boogie from. They have hella, they probably had like 6 or 10 of those. They also had a variegated Monstera, but obviously, they're not gonna leave it out. They probably still have it, but, they're not gonna leave it out with everybody freaking stealing from nurseries and shit. So, but yeah, so I left the nursery empty handed, didn't really find anything I wanted. So now I don't know what we're gonna do. I don't know what the next clip is gonna be, but while I'm here, public service announcement. The therapy tees are coming back, but they're gonna be long sleeve. All right, y'all, it is day 2 of Bay Area plant shopping. We're gonna hit up some spots called the Dry Garden and Cactus Jungle. And we're gonna end this whole debate once and for all if Bay Area nurseries are better than LA nurseries. Right now we're at Costco getting gas. And once I'm done getting gas, I'll catch back up with y'all.
Okay. I didn't mention this earlier, but I'm sure you guys know this is the next day. We are here in Oakland at the Dry Garden. So let's go inside and see what they got. Actually, this might be Berkeley. I don't know, man. Oakland, Berkeley, one of the two. I might come back for this. I really like how these look. This one's pretty cool too.
So this got flowers, which is pretty nice.
Kind of looks like a jade, but way cooler. Okay. Here is where I'm assuming all the cactus and succulents are. Whole bunch of agave. A lot of Amex. This is pretty cool. Euphorbia limbi, or whatever it was called, however you pronounce it, reminds me of like a Dr. Seuss plant, which is probably why I like it a lot.
Look at these.
These are $175. These are nuts.
This one, $150. $19.95. These are cool little succulents.
Have like fur on the end. $6.95 for these guys. I have like one succulent that's doing good. Or maybe two, so I don't want to ruin it. And just let them two do their thing. Whole bunch of Amex. Lots of new growth. This place is pretty dope. Oh. Now we're talking. Agave. No, this is aloe. Wow. It got eerily quiet as soon as I entered here too, which is a good sign that I might find something good, or that it's just good energy in here. One of the two. Little baby Madagascar palms. I have to sneeze. Oh shit. Whoever said bless you, thank you. Oh my god. Are these whale fins? No, I don't think so. That's crazy. 1995 for this. What else? These are some type of Sansevierias though. What else? What's this? All these are Sansevierias. Oh my god. Oh my god. Is this a crested Madagascar palm? It sure is. Holy shit. How much is this? See if I can get in here. There's no price, which means it's either expensive as hell or not for sale. Oh my god, bro, this is beautiful. Look at this thing. Oh my. You know, for something like this, I'm thinking like $200 or something. It's pretty big. Oh my god. And it's like extremely crested too. Wow. Do I pick up that phone? The phone's right there. There's also a camera. What else is in here? Oh, this is do not enter. This looks pretty cool. I don't know what this is though. Oh, some type of euphorbia. Wow. Dang, I'm kind of blown away by that amic. Madagascar palm. I've seen them crested before in like Dallas. One of the homies has bought one from a nursery in like Austin or Dallas or something like that, and that was my only time seeing it. I didn't even know they came crested or they were available or even able to go crested. This is nice. That's definitely a dream plant to have, but not anytime soon because I'm not trying to spend all that money. There's more Madagascar palms up there. All right, so what I'm gonna do is turn off the camera. Damn, can y'all even see my face? What I'm gonna do is turn off the camera and enjoy some time in here. See if I can find anything I want. These guys are pretty crazy. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I've been scoping them out on Instagram and the interweb. 360 for this guy. And then there's little babies over here. This one right here, 95 for this. So as you can see, they're pretty expensive and rare. 110, but not for me. Can't do it. Still thinking about this though. Just thinking too hard on it. Probably not gonna get it. So I'll put it back. Kind of like this weird one a lot. I know a lot of people like these guys. Can't really distinguish the price on it. Ain't no way that's $20, so $420 probably. But it's pretty cool. All that new growth, baby totem pole. Goes all the way over there. Same thing with this one. And there's another one here as well. It's all tangled over there. Shit, it goes, it stops there. I don't know if you guys can see that, but damn, it's pretty crazy.
Oh, I'm back. I just spent like, I think I spent like 2 hours in that damn nursery. I thought I was about to spend like 15 minutes, 30 minutes. But here I am, 2 hours later, in the car. I just ended up with a pot for the crested golden barrel. And I actually ended up talking to the guy that owns the spot. There is a bunch of Thai constellations, or albos. I don't know which one. But there are a bunch of them, probably like 10 or 20 of them shits up in the office that he has. But there's like a waiting list of 130 people. So, yeah. About that. But overall, that nursery, I'd rate it like a shit 10 out of 10. Why not? It was pretty nice. I had a good selection. I didn't even know it had the houseplant stuff, so the fact that it also has houseplants and a good selection of it is even a plus. There's stuff that I didn't even know that existed. And there's like the Raphidophora tetrasferma, the mini monstera. Like, I didn't know that it couldn't even grow like that, so that was pretty cool to see. I always see them trailing upward. I never see them like, you know, just all wild and open and shit. So that's pretty cool to see that. It's pretty cool to talk to the guy. So yeah, I definitely rated it a 10 out of 10. They had a lot of nice alocasias, like $75. But there was a few that I wouldn't mind getting. But I'm gonna definitely come back with Plain Lady P. She is the alocasia person. So if she wants it, we'll get it. I just basically put the pressure on her. So, but nah, just kidding. I was about to go to Cactus Jungle, but they're open on Wednesday to Sunday. All right, that's enough though. I'll probably just end up heading back home now. Yeah, definitely. There's definitely nothing like that in LA. I mean, there's a few gems like that, but I've never seen any houseplants like that. It's a cool little vibe. Guy's cool. They even have albos, Thai constellations. So again, 10 out of 10 spot. Highly recommend. This LA versus the Bay houseplant nursery tour is getting real serious, man. I tell you that. That one, I think the Bay wins, honestly. So we'll see the next spot.